kopela di swani mwana shoti baika KF. Sweet Jesus, what a wonder you are, you are brighter than the morning sun. To greet you all in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
We would like to greet you all in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
We realize that there is power in that name.
Amen.
In that name there is healing.
In
that name there is deliverance. Whatever you need is in that name. That is why the Bible says, at that name, every knee shall bow.
Hallelujah.
Every tongue confess that He is Lord.
Amen.
How many are happy to be in the house of the Lord?
Hallelujah.
Can we all just say amen?
Amen.
Can we all say hallelujah?
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Thank Pastor Malika.
Rata ulebua Muruti Malika
for his invitation.
For memo ya gare
that we can be with you here today. We love him. We respect him. May God bless his ministry. May bless his family. We would like to greet all the ministers here, the deacons,
Madikoni,
the trustees,
trustee,
and the church in large, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And then we bring our greetings from Pyramid. May the Lord bless you all. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord. Now, before I get into my message, I normally like to say that I've got a very nice preaching style. That I read a scripture, read quotations, make few comments. So in that way I'm safe.
Yeah.
So that I can just preach what Brother Branham said. Amen.
Amen.
And I trust you won't get offended.
Ow.
By hearing me saying Brother Branham said. Amen. Because when Moses went into the cloud, when he came out of the cloud, Moses said, "Thus saith the Lord."
Hallelujah.
But when Joshua came, Joshua never said, "Thus saith the Lord."
Joshua
said, "Brother Moses said."
Amen.
Now Brother Branham went into the cloud. He came out of the cloud. And then he says, "Thus saith the Lord."
Yes.
Now me today,
nali ho.
I never went into the cloud.
Asiki ki el ru.
And never came out of the cloud.
Ibi asiki ki el ru.
I cannot say that saith the Lord.
Kasi rimu re na uri.
But I can say Brother Branham said.
Ifela kitori Brother Branham urile.
Amen.
Amen.
Maybe let me read a quote before I get into my message.
Riki li balile situpulo apilanka ya mulaite.
Brother Branham says in the message, the end time sign seed.
Brother Branham uri mulaite wa pegu ya mikhabu felo.
He says here a few days ago.
Uri moma tatiasa makai.
In our church.
Moputeo me.
I was going to preach there on a Sunday.
Kinekio rera ka sonta.
They brought a little girl there on a stretcher.
Ile batlisa musizanya na ka stretcher.
They called me in the night time on the road.
Ba ile ba founela ke le tsileng
mushiro. They said this girl cannot leave.
Ba re musizana wo akasiphile.
The cancer was so bad.
Cancer in AMP.
She was about 17 years old.
Nyana le mingwaga ya 17.
She can't get there.
Akase gona o fitla mo.
She is going to die before she gets there.
O tlhokofala pele a ka fitla mo.
It was a pitiful case.
Ne ile le mo le shuru.
A lovely little child of 17 years old.
Mwana o ratehang wa mingwaga ya 17.
Now Brother Branham says.
Brother Branham
says to prove something to my church.
O khontisetsa phuthego ya ka sesengwe.
So Brother Branham did this with an intention to prove something.
Amen.
He says, I never touched the child at all.
Uri asanga ka khwatha ngwana le gati.
I never as much as touched her.
Asanga ka baka mukhwatha.
He says, I walked in.
Uri kile ka tsena.
Laying on a stretcher.
A robeti mo stretcher.
Because there was other sick people there.
Ka ba no ba le balwetse ba bangwe gona.
But I was concerned about the child.
Ifela ne ke khwathegile ka ngwana wo.
To catch her spirit.
Uri ke bona o tshwara moya.
When I spoke to her. When I spoke to her, and she seemed like a very fine little girl.
Unahala ile mwana nyana wa musitsana o muka
o mo muti. I see no reason.
Kine ke sina libaka.
Why that child should feel a premature grave?
La uri mwana akaba aya libitleng na go so fitla.
And that has to be the devil trying to take her life.
Eh ne satan alika o tsiya bophilo ba
gago. So I never touched the child.
Yes, ya asanga ka khwatha mwana o le gati.
Jesus, I went to the pulpit with the way.
Uri kine ka ya pulpit
and stayed right with the way.
Amen.
And the word healed her so instantly.
Amen.
For this until she got up.
Amen.
And walk away. It's all right now.
Amen.
Living like anybody else.
Amen.
Can't find a trace of it anywhere. Never even touched. Hey. See, the word went forth.
Amen.
She believed the word.
Amen.
And the word is God's life.
Amen.
And God's power.
Yes.
And the word is what does it. The word heals the sick. Amen. Now, this morning, I'm not going to touch you at all. The only thing that I'm going to do, I will come to the pulpit with the way.
Amen.
And stay right with the way. Amen.
The
word is God's life.
Amen.
And God's power.
Yes.
It is the word that does it.
Amen.
If you believe the word this morning, when the word is going forward, I might not mention your sickness.
Amen.
I might not mention your situation. But I will come with the word of the living God. And the word will bring the results. Can we say amen? In the message, another message he says, you notice. Many times I see the visions over somebody and then I would speak. If they don't respond, it moves right over to someone else. Is that right? In another message he says, now he gets into discernment. He says there's a kidney trouble lady. Right back there with a kidney condition. He says, you believe that God makes you well, lady?
Hallelujah!
If you do, raise up your hand.
How do men understand?
Accept it.
Amen.
Respond to God's call.
Amen.
Brother Branham says to that lady,
Brother Branham,
he says, you missed it.
Are
you? He says, I'll show you whether you missed it or not.
Ki ta mbotsa ri imisitse o ba su.
He said it falls on this lady sitting right there with a handkerchief over her mouth.
Ari iwetse ka bogatsedi o le ka mo a tshwere handkerchief mo molomo wa.
This lady sitting right here,
ga ke di o tuti mo.
Had a back towel too.
Ona le tlhala mo kokotlo.
That's right, lady, didn't it?
Ki tere shu ga ke di a go jalo.
Yes sir.
Hey,
you just come from an operation.
Utswa operation ka
cancer operation.
Can operation ya kankere.
Yes, that's right.
Ki tere shu.
Your name is Virginia.
Lina la ha o ki Virginia.
He says you are healed, Virginia.
Are u fodile.
Jesus Christ makes you well. Hey, Jesus
Christ is going
for this. And there was a brother in the church.
Ki bile dona le abuti mo putegong.
Who was not even responding to what Brother Branham said.
Ona sabe a responda mo se Branham ne a se.
Brother Branham says to the brother.
Brother Branham ile go abuti.
You missed it, Mr. Anderson.
Are u miss it, Mr. Anderson.
Because you didn't respond. Now this morning,
there no be song here.
You must aim in the way.
Amen.
And when you aim in the way, God will bring whatever you need. It is your response to the way that brings the result. Don't be a Mr. Anderson this morning. But be a Sister Virginia. And respond to God's call. Now I feel relaxed.
We are looking for no preacher.
Now I can preach.
We are not there.
Let us all stand on our feet.
Ari ya beleka mantu arena.
Amen.
I'm not going to be long.
Nga sto tsana ko,
but I'm not going to cut my message.
Ifela nga sto gaula mlaetsa wa.
So if you say amen,
how re amen,
then we will maybe close quickly.
Re ka tswalela ka pila mo
hlongwe. Amen. Let us turn our Bibles.
Ari bule Bible tsa rena
in the book of John chapter 4.
Mo bukeng ya John wa bune.
Then we'll read verse 23.
Go back to verse 23
and 24.
The 24.
And read John chapter 17.
Rabala John 17.
Only verse 1.
Verse 23.
And then we'll read interchangeably.
Go back to rechange.
Now, John chapter 4, verse 23. The Bible says, "But the hour cometh, and now it is, when the true worshippers shall worship the Father in spirit and in truth."
Amen.
For the Father seeketh such to worship Him.
Fela go tlotla le baka le biale ke lona le o ba rapedi ba mmagontshe ba tlo go rapela tate ka moya le ka thirisho le bona tate o nyaka ba ba mo rapela go ka mogwa o.
God is a spirit, and they that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth.
Modimo ke moya. Gomme ba ba mo rapela go ba tlo mo rapela ka moya le ka thirisho le ka go relisha.
John chapter 17.
John 17.
Verse 1. This way spake Jesus and lifted up his eyes to heaven and said, Father, the hour is come. Glorify thy Son, that thy Son also may glorify thee.
Amen.
Jesu re a itse allo. Alelalala le go dimong are tate le baka le tlile ne ya morwa le tago gore le wena o be le tago ka yena morwao.
Amen.
Amen.
Let us bow our heads.
Are rapeleng.
Mighty God and eternal Father.
Yes.
Amen.
We have read what we believe to be your word.
Yes, Lord.
We know it is easy for every man to turn the pages of the Bible, but it takes the Holy Spirit himself.
Hallelujah.
To turn the pages of our hearts.
Amen.
Lord God Almighty, give us context out of the scriptures that we have read. May the word of God go in power and demonstration of the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Father God, speak through me and hear through your children.
Yes.
That at the end of the service, the glory and the honor and the adoration will come to no man but you and you alone.
Amen.
Heal the sick by the preaching of the word. Deliver the bound. Provide to the needy, O God, that we can leave this place rejoicing.
Amen.
We can commit all these things believing in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
You may take your seats.
Now,
for a title this morning,
for
I want to speak on the hour has come.
The
hour has come. Now, maybe to lay a background, the Bible says in the book of Malachi 4.
Bibili ya bulela mo Malachi wa bule.
He says, behold, I will send you Elijah the prophet.
Iri bona ke rumela Malachi ya mo profeta.
Before the coming of the great and dreadful day of the Lord.
Bile hautla ali tati
And he shall turn the heart of the fathers to the children. And the heart of the children to their fathers. Lest I come and smite the earth with a curse. Now we all know that outside the message of Malachi
4,
the earth is cursed.
Yeah.
Outside the message of Malachi
4,
we don't have hope.
Amen.
Our only hope
is
in the message of Malachi
4.
Amen. The message of Malachi 4 becomes a blessing
before
the curse.
Amen.
And the purpose of Malachi 4 is not to start a new organization.
Or a new church, or a new denomination.
But the message of Malachi 4 is to turn our hearts to the Pentecostal fathers again.
Amen.
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 Amen. You know, when you go to any government,
whatever how we are
moving,
or
any company, or a school.
Yeah.
What we call a vision and a vision statement.
Yeah. Vision statement.
Amen.
Amen.
So maybe if you come to this school,
mm-hmm.
they will tell you that the mission of this school
is
to produce 100% pass rate.
My guy has colossal 100% pass rate
of the matriculants. So if you come to this school,
how it has colossal
become the best. A cricket player. You haven't fulfilled the mission. If you become the best class, the best prefect.
How about prefect?
It is wonderful. But you haven't come to the vision of the school. So now, if your heart is not turned. Then your worship here is in vain.
Right.
But there is a special class of people that are not worshipping in vain.
Amen.
Because they are the beneficiaries of the message of Malachi 4. Right, Brother
Branham
says here,
Brother Branham
in the Laodicean Church Age,
he
says now, the messenger of Malachi 4 in Revelation
10
is going to do two things. One according to Malachi
4,
he will turn the hearts of the children to their fathers.
Yes. Amen.
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 He will reveal the mysteries of the seven thunders of Revelation 10, which are the revelations contained in the seven seals.
Amen.
All right.
Seven seals.
It will be this divine revealed mystery truth
that
will literally turn the heart of the children to the Pentecostal fathers. Exactly so. So Brother Branham now shows us the mission and the vision statement. And for this to happen, Brother Surprise, we must preach the baptism of the Holy Ghost. What made the Pentecostal fathers was the baptism of the Holy Ghost. They wrote the book of Acts.
Amen.
And that is what I'm going to preach on this morning.
Amen.
The baptism of the Holy Ghost.
Hallelujah.
When they were in the upper room, in Acts chapter 2, the Spirit of God, like a mighty rushing wind, came in the upper room. And every believer in the upper room accepted a lick of fire. Amen.
Hallelujah.
The Spirit of God. And the Bible says they spoke with new tongues. As the Spirit gave utterance. Now, the baptism of the Holy Ghost is what made the Pentecostal fathers.
Hallelujah.
Now, 10 days later, in Acts chapter 3,
more to wrong some
round. We see James and John.
We wanna James and John
going into the temple.
By your temple
as their custom was.
We are going to be now
in the name. They found a lame man.
He never quit as one.
That was lame from his mother's womb.
Alright.
Amen.
And when Peter and John get there,
yeah, no, Peter, John,
they said to the lame man, silver and gold, we don't have, but such as I have, I give unto you.
Amen.
I cannot give.
How can you be?
You
can't afford to
move. What you don't have.
Amen.
So before the day of Pentecost, Brother Branham says, they passed that gate many times. But it was only after they received the baptism of the Holy Ghost that they can look at the young man and they spoke boldly. And they say, silver and gold, we don't have, but such as I have, I give unto you.
Yeah.
So when you've got the Holy Ghost, you've got something to give.
Yeah.
And the young man did not remain lame. The Bible says, immediately.
Oh man,
immediately. And Brother Branham says, Jesus passed that gate many times. But certain things, Brother Branham says, certain things, he lives for us to do.
Hallelujah.
So he left. He didn't heal that man. Not because Jesus did not have power to heal him.
No.
But he waited for these brothers to get the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
When they got the Holy Ghost, they were enjoyed with the power from and they say silver and gold.
Why never put it over in the
but such as I have, rise up and walk.
Amen.
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 It was when Ananias and
Sapphira,
when they came to church,
and
lied to Peter. And Peter said,
Peter,
you have not lied unto men, but you have lied unto God. Now the question is, where was God? God was veiled in a man in the form of the Holy Spirit. That's why today we don't need a church.
Amen.
What we need is the baptism of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
When Peter,
Peter
went into a revival in
Samaria,
the Bible says he preached Christ unto the
people.
That's what we need today. We don't need message delinquent behind the
pulpit. Amen.
But we want people
to
preach Christ unto the
people.
Amen.
That's right.
We must do the same.
Amen.
Oh, brother.
Amen.
We must receive
the
baptism of the Holy
Spirit.
Amen.
That I said today.
How's our quota system?
Get this one. If I
have a
you must receive
the
baptism of the Holy Spirit.
Right.
Brother Branham says, in the message where I think Pentecost failed,
he
says, you know, in my travel of 10 years in the evangelistic work, I've 23 years in the service of the Lord. And I have found two classes of people. And that is the fundamentalist. And the Pentecostals. And the fundamentalist. Positionally knows where they stand. But they haven't got too much faith with it.
Alright.
And the Pentecostals has got a lot of faith. But don't know who they are.
Oh.
And where they stand.
Yeah.
It's like a man that's got money in the bank. And he don't know how to write a check.
asatibi umwala cheke.
And the other man
mutobu we
can write a check.
Ukhona umwala cheke
only he ain't got no money.
Ifela hana chelete.
Alright.
So if you could ever get them together.
Ifela how ba khona ba kopanya batho
bawo. You will really have it.
Yes,
so,
amen.
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 Yeah.
Prophet's mission.
Exactly.
Was to get the Pentecostals and the fundamentals to come together. In other words, the prophet's mission was to get somebody with the baptism of the
Holy
Spirit and anchored in the word. God does not want you to have the word only without the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Or have the Holy Spirit only
without the
word. He wants you to have both.
Amen.
Exactly right.
Can we say amen?
Amen.
For your car to move.
You can have
a very beautiful car. Nice Mercedes-Benz. Polish and clean the engine. Polish the tires.
Polish the
but as long as there is no spark in that
you
car,
car.
I will pass you by with my Golf. Because in my Golf there is a spark.
Amen.
That's why Paul says, our gospel did not come unto you in word only.
Amen.
But
in
power.
Amen.
And demonstration. Amen. Of the Holy Ghost. Then you have both. You are in a position where God wants you to be. Now in the scripture we have read, the Bible says,
but
the hour cometh and now is when the true worshippers shall worship the Father in spirit and in truth.
Yes,
God is looking for worshippers. We will worship him in truth and in spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Not in truth only, but in spirit also. Not only in spirit, but also in truth.
Yeah.
And the hour cometh, and now it is the hour, when God is looking for worshippers. How many worshippers are here today? It's
amen.
Like 60% of you. Lord, how many worshippers are here today? God is looking for worshippers.
Yes.
People that worship God under any circumstance. Whether there is food on the table, whether there is no food on the table, God wants worshippers.
Yes.
Whether you've got money in your bank account, whether you don't have money in your bank account, God is looking for worshippers.
Amen.
Say amen. Somebody.
Amen.
God is looking for some people that when they are sick, they can raise their hands.
Amen.
And give God the glory.
Amen.
When they are healthy, they can raise their hands. That's a true worshipper.
And
such worshippers confuse the devil. Because at home you don't have food. But when you come to church, you raise your hand. You say amen to the word.
Amen.
And this morning, I want to say all of us,
yes,
let us confuse the devil.
Amen.
Let's say amen to the way.
Amen.
Forget about what you left at home.
Yes.
Forget about what you're going to do tomorrow.
Amen.
Concentrate on him.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Brother Branham, what was the Holy Ghost given for? He says, now look. One closing remark.
Hey.
But I'm not closing myself.
Amen.
I've just started.
Yeah.
And remember then, it is absolutely now to you people, it's absolutely absolutely essential.
What
and necessary and compelling and compulsory. Let me read again. It's absolutely essential.
Yeah.
That
and necessary and compelling.
And compulsory. That you receive the Holy Ghost. If you don't, you can't come up in the resurrection. Let me emphasize again. To receive the Holy Ghost. Church members. A church member is a dangerous person. And then the pastor next week comes.
Yeah.
Ruti, we make it a muata. He preaches 30 minutes.
Arera 30 minutes.
And close.
Atuale.
The very same person.
They go out.
Comes and complains.
What happened? What more?
We cannot leave our home on a Sunday.
The pastor
comes and preaches 30 minutes.
Ruti, arera, it's a taro. 30 minutes.
Church members.
Give my little water.
It's cold.
How told ya?
They sit at home.
When
it's hot,
how fisa?
They complain. When it's raining, they don't come to church. Church members. When there is a graduation, they don't come to church. When there is a society, burial society. We don't need church members. Let me preach that.
Amen.
You see, yesterday, when I was driving out of Soshanguve, I saw people painting their faces. Because Orlando Pirates and Kaizer Chiefs were playing. If you see people arguing, there are two things. It's either this person, they don't have a ticket, or they are late. People who are on time, they are pushing their bags. They are always trying to check in. And then they give the person an ID. And then they ask,
so ba bona.
Where are you flying to, sir? You see, in the book of Exodus, when the death angel came, if there was no blood on the doorpost, you were not going to negotiate with the death angel. Say, ah, no, you see, if you come tomorrow, at least you will find everything in order.
Hey, what are you doing, my
son? Tomorrow, brother.
Hey, listen to me, someone
today.
You
want everybody in here to be filled with the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
The Holy Ghost. It's a prerequisite.
Yeah.
Into the rapture. You see, when you come to school, and you say, I want to do medicine, and they tell you that you need to pass your math in metric with the symbol C, higher grade. And then physical science, C, higher grade.
Amen.
And then maybe biology.
Amen.
And then now you go to matric.
At the end of the year,
you write your exam.
January,
when they release the newspaper,
and
you get your results. Mathematics. F.
No.
Physical science. H.
Biology.
F. Sepedi.
Sepedi.
A.
A.
Ah.
And then Africans.
Africans.
B.
Bancha.
English. C.
C.
What?
And then you take your results. Go to Medunza.
Why are Medunza?
And you gave them to the dean.
The
dean checks. I'm sorry, sir. Such kind of people.
But what's going to
they don't do medicine. Because here, we want people who can factorize. We want somebody who can do linear programming. We want somebody in physical science. That can do a covalent bonding. This result. Go to the Department of Education. You can do teaching and measure in languages. We have got a good symbols. Languages.
Amen.
But the prerequisite for medicine,
science,
maths,
biology.
You don't need to pay in medicine. So for you to get into the rapture, we don't want you to come to church. That is good. But we want you to receive the baptism. Without the baptism of the Holy Ghost, forget about the rapture.
Yeah.
There is a brother in Branham Tabernacle.
Abutiko Branham Tabernacle.
And then this brother, his name is Brother Charlie Cox.
Yeah, Brother Ubutiwoki, Charlie Cox.
Brother Charlie Cox.
Yeah, nah, Charlie Chukoko.
Was there when Brother Branham preached the service of the Holy Ghost?
Alright.
Brother Branham arrera the service of the Holy Ghost.
He says after Brother Branham preached the service of the Holy Ghost.
What Brother Branham has no faith or rera the service of.
He made it clear.
Uile aikalusa tui
that you cannot get into the rapture. Unless you receive the baptism of the Holy Ghost. And Brother
Charlie Cox
said everyone that was in Branham Tabernacle was so desperate
Motalelo.
Until they started to cry. Hunger for the baptism of the Holy Ghost. Charlie Cox said that message of the Holy Ghost changed the attitude of the people. It was made so clear that without the Holy Ghost, there is no rapture.
Amen.
And I want to make it so clear to you this afternoon that without the Holy Ghost, there is no rapture.
Amen.
So it's a disparate hour that we receive the Holy Ghost and to be sure that you have can we say amen?
Amen.
Amen.
How many wants the Holy Ghost? Some of you have the Holy Ghost. But you need the refilling of the Holy Ghost. Without the Holy Ghost, you cannot even challenge the devil. Without the Holy Ghost, you cannot challenge the devil. It was Jacob one time.
It was Jacob one time.
Remember Jacob?
He
loved
Esau.
With the birthright.
Okay.
Amen.
Amen.
And then Jacob, just cooked a red
soup.
Amen.
Amen.
And then after he cooked a soup, then he robbed Esau from the birthright. Jacob ran away.
Jacob
went to his uncle Laban. When he got to
Laban,
he robbed Laban again. He put poplar sticks in water. And then when the kettles
come
and drink, and then they are pregnant inside. When they looked at the popular sticks, they affected the baby on the inside. And then when they gave birth, Jacob said, "This is yours."
Jacob
Laban.
That
is how Jacob got rich.
But
one day, he realized, I need to meet my brother Esau. But I cannot meet Esau in this state. Because Esau, when he was coming the other way, Esau was not going to make friends.
Yeah.
Esau was very angry.
Amen.
He wanted to kill this man. And then Jacob.
We are not Jacob.
Got a desperate hour.
Desperate.
And then he got the Bible says. The man in the book of Jacob wrestled with the Lord.
Jacob
L-O-R-D.
Yeah.
Which
Amen.
Is God.
Yes.
He wrestled with him.
The
whole night. And the breaking of a day. The angel of the Lord.
Yeah.
Asked mercy from Jacob.
Muhammad.
He said, please, leave me alone. Jacob said, I will not leave you.
You
and I believe today, you came with that attitude to change.
Hallelujah.
I will not leave this place until I receive the baptism of the Holy Ghost.
Glory to Jesus.
Matthew
25.
There were 10 virgins. All these virgins.
So let me have
to take were coming to church.
Were
sanctified. They all had their long dresses. They were all singing in the choir. But there was a difference at the midnight cry.
Brother
Brennan. Had to have an extra oil.
An
extra oil.
It's not
your name in the book of a church.
Amen.
The extra oil. The extra oil. It is the baptism of the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Right.
And the baptism of the Holy Ghost is found under the seventh seal. And the seventh seal is Christ himself.
Amen.
Amen.
John
chapter
3,
John
Obraru,
verse 5.
Five.
Jesus says,
Jesus,
verily, verily, I say unto thee, except a man be born of water and of the Spirit, he cannot enter the kingdom of God. So if you're only born of water, the journey is not complete.
Amen.
You just started a journey of salvation. But you must go all the way.
And
be born of the Spirit.
Unless
you are born of water and the Spirit, you cannot enter the kingdom. Alright. Now let me give you an example. How many here know a cucumber? All of us, we know a cucumber. If you want to turn a cucumber into a pickle,
how do you change a cucumber into a pickle?
They say,
but
you boil water.
You
cut that cucumber and you dip it once into boiling water. Once. And you take it out. But that is not the end result of making that pickle.
How did a pickle?
Right. You take that pickle that was dipped into the boiling water. And I want to make sure that you don't dip it three times. You dip it
once.
You dip it once. You take it out. Now you take that cucumber. You put it in a vinegar solution. And in the vinegar solution. You don't dip it and take it out. You place it there until it is changed. When it is changed, it is now a pickle. You can take a cucumber and turn it into a pickle.
Why change it?
But you cannot turn a pickle.
If fair away, no one's changed a pickle.
Back into a cucumber.
Why is a
cucumber?
So when you are a believer,
how do you make?
We take you into water
once.
Yeah.
But in the baptism of the Holy Ghost, we don't dip you like we dip you into the water. In the Holy Ghost, we place you there.
Until
your attitude is changed.
That's right. Yeah, man.
Amen. Amen. One message
says,
Holy Ghost, change your attitude.
Exactly. Amen.
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 Can we say amen?
Amen? Amen.
It must change your attitude.
Yeah.
It will change your dress code.
Exactly right.
It will change the way you talk to people. You see these people that are always moody. Moody people.
Hey,
they sleep happy, they wake up angry.
Hey, that is an evil
spirit upon you.
Amen.
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 They can talk to other people, but they can talk to other people. You don't have the Holy Ghost.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You didn't say amen.
Amen. Amen.
Say it again.
Yes.
If you are a moody person, you don't have the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Amen.
How do you sleep happy? And wake up angry. You don't have the Holy Ghost.
Yeah.
And especially sisters.
Yeah.
Moody people.
But what the moods?
You greet them.
What do we?
They just go this way.
But
I'm saying God bless you. But you don't greet me.
If fela awudumedisi.
What, the devil is in trouble.
Hey, Satan, I'm not
there. I will preach whether you say amen or
not.
Amen.
Because the Holy Ghost
is
still with your
attitude.
You know someone
who
has the Holy Ghost.
It's
a sweet person. It's like honey. You always want to be with them. But somebody that does not have the Holy Ghost.
Really?
Because you don't know how is the mood today? If you are a moody person, after I preach, come here, we lay hands on you.
Amen.
Amen.
Satan will go over.
Hallelujah.
We need the Holy Ghost.
Yes. Amen.
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 People that are sweet.
But who balimunati?
The Bible says in the book of John, chapter 3.
Bibili iri kuchoni wabraro.
That which is born of flesh is flesh.
Shesi tuchingi nama kina.
And that which is born of the spirit is spirit.
Shesi tuchingi moya kimoya.
Mother, Lord, I say unto thee.
Si makale hakili mutakiri kili
heradi. Born again. Let me say, Church of the Living God.
You
must be born again.
You birth.
Is the baptism of the Holy Ghost.
And
you birth.
Is
not only for intellectual people.
Exactly.
God can reveal Himself.
An
old lady. In the jungles of Africa.
Born
in Africa.
Yeah.
And God. Can reveal Himself to the most uneducated people.
Amen.
Hebrews chapter 4, verse 7. The Bible says, again, he limiteth a certain day, saying in David, today, after so long a time, as it is said, today if you will hear his voice, harden not your heart.
Hallelujah!
Church of God, today, when you hear this word, don't harden your heart. It's me, O Lord.
Amen.
It's not my brother. It's not my sister. It's not my pastor. It's not the ministering brother. It's me, O Lord.
Amen.
Standing in the need of prayer. Today, when you hear his voice, harden not your heart. Hebrews chapter 4, verse 9. The Bible says, there remaineth therefore a rest. To the people of God. My question to you today, have you entered into that rest? What is that rest? It is the baptism of the Holy Ghost. If you did not find that rest, don't rest until you find that rest.
Amen.
Let me repeat again. If you did not find that rest, don't rest until you find that rest.
Amen.
Yes. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
In question and answers of
1964,
they asked Brother Branham a question. Children have to have an experience to have the Holy Spirit. Or if they see the end time message. Do they have the Holy Spirit? Let me read the question again. Do your children have to have an experience, have an experience to have the Holy Spirit? Or if they see the end time message, do they have the Holy Spirit?
But
Brother Branham answers the question.
Brother Branham says,
everyone,
yes,
must have an experience. Your children cannot go in on no other way but the same way you do.
Amen.
They've got to be born again.
There's no grandchildren in the kingdom of God. They are all children.
All right.
They must have it. You must have an experience with God.
Amen.
To go in. Just the same as you. Now I hope I can get it. So in the kingdom of God, there is no grandchildren. Everyone must have the baptism.
Yes.
Not because you come with your children to church. Or to
get
a message church. Then
they've
got the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Everyone must meet God. Everyone here. You've got a right to the baptism of the Holy Ghost. The same way Peter had the Holy Ghost at the day of Pentecost. The same way Bartholomew had the baptism of the Holy Ghost. Amen.
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 Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Something that you know that you have received the baptism of the Holy Ghost. Personal experience. Somebody can say, but how do I know when I've got it? Does your life produce it?
Amen.
Are you living the life of Christ? You see, in the book of Exodus, Joshua took over. And the Bible says in the book of Exodus, God told Joshua, take sharp knives and circumcise again. Why? Because there were children, Brother Opius, that were born in the message, that did not have an experience. You need to have your personal experience. Not
wait
on somebody else's experience.
Amen.
You can't depend on who might
have your own experience. In the message testing for life, the Bible says, the prophet says, the hour is coming. And now is. That we can't play church no more. If God's way, it's God working in the church. We must have it. The rapture is at hand. That we cannot play this message anymore. We
need to
get serious with God. Serious with God. We cannot compromise with this message.
Hey.
The hour has come. That God is demanding serious. Somebody next to you is sleeping. Tell them this is not a bedroom. Check the one that is behind you. Check that is one in front of you.
Amen.
Make sure that everybody is awake. We need to get in serious with God.
Amen.
Not one foot in church, one foot in the well. Be Jesus on a Sunday and be Judas on a Monday. There are people like that.
Amen.
Jesus on a Sunday night. Monday.
Judas.
Hey.
But we need to get serious with God. Friends, if you look at the condition of the world, the pressure that is building up in the Middle East, you can see that things are getting ready for the Battle of Armageddon.
Yeah.
The Battle of Armageddon. It is the battle that started in heaven between Lucifer and Micah.
Yeah.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Yeah.
And that battle, it was over position. So in that battle, it was over position.
And that battle was supposed to take place in the First World War. And when it was supposed to gravitate in the Battle of
Armageddon,
John in the Book of Revelation 7, he says, hold the winds. Praise the people. Hold the winds.
The people.
Until we have sealed the servants of our God.
Uswaya.
The 144,000.
Amen.
And we know
The 144,000
cannot be sealed until the Gentiles are sealed.
Amen.
And according to the Bible, a seal is the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Ephesians 4 verse 13.
Take
it right. Not the Holy Spirit, then we are sealed unto the day of redemption. We don't have too much time here.
Brother Branham says,
the Laodicean church age, it is the shortest time. In another message, he says here that we have, says, the rapture should have already happened. That is, why are we still here? Peter wrote, God willing that any should perish.
God not willing that any should perish.
His long suffering towards us. That we should all come to repentance. It
cannot
be business as usual.
Amen.
We need the baptism of the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
And the first thing that we need to do, it is to clean our lives.
Amen.
God is not going to come and pour himself into a dirty
vessel.
We must clean our lives.
Yeah.
Now, let us start with the cleaning now. Can I preach?
Amen.
Amen.
Without any fear or faith.
Yeah.
Hebrews chapter 12.
12.
Therefore, seeing we have all come past about with a great cloud of witnesses, let us lay aside every weight and the sin which doth easily beset us, and let us run. With patience. We have come to a time where we must lay aside every weight. You see, when people are running in the Olympics, Pastor, if people are running at the Olympics, you can't come there with an overall. And soft tissues, boots, and carrying a bag on top to prove a point. Hey, you don't need time to prove a point.
Amen.
Lay aside every way that will easily beset you, and let us run. You can't run this race with a hatred in your heart. Lay aside.
Amen.
You cannot run this race with strife and malice. You cannot run this race when you've got differences with one another, with unconfessed sin. Offload, believer, offload. Let us lay aside every way.
Yes.
Amen.
And let us run.
Amen.
Safe tissues.
The boots.
It's not for running.
As
it's
not
waking.
It's a miracle.
Lay aside.
Be like a truco.
In Matthew chapter 10.
Matthew 10.
Verse 39.
39.
The Bible says,
Bible,
he that findeth his life shall lose it. And he that loseth his life
will
gain it. For my sake
shall
find it.
The
way God operates
is
different from the way the world
operates. When
you come into Christ,
in
order to find your
life, you must
lose
it. In the world,
in order to find your
life, you must
control your
life. But
you must be willing
to confess
that, Lord, this morning I'm going to offload.
Yeah.
You see, yeah, many people don't like such kind of messages.
Because
in every church,
there are
two classes of people.
They
are another group.
They like
you. When you tell them about predestination,
that
you were chosen in God before the foundation of the world,
before they say,
this brother is a preacher.
Alright.
So the other group, they want you to always shamble. So if you preach about predestination and you don't shamble, they say, no, he's compromising.
Yeah. Oh, all
right.
So, but we need a balanced diet.
Yeah.
And let me make it clear that if you don't have the Holy Ghost,
your
coming to church is in vain.
You
need to have the Holy Ghost for preachers to be satisfied is to see every believer filled with the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
But you must be willing to offload. You are not going to receive the baptism of the Holy Ghost until you come in the open and say, I've got a hidden life, which is a life of the devil. But today, let us expose the devil.
Amen.
Brother Branham says
here,
now they were light-footed.
I
remember when the Lord forgave me, it felt like £1 million went off my
back.
I never even touched the step going towards the house. I didn't know nothing about shouting. Wish I could have that experience again right now. I would make for that time. I know something that had happened. I went in the house, grabbed my songbook, and then my mother said,
Mama,
what's the matter? I said, I don't know. I grabbed my Bible. I couldn't read it. I was too nervous. Happy. She said, what's the matter? I don't know. I slipped out of the door. Went down. And there's a big railroad track around behind our place. And I ran down the rail track. And I jumped in the air as hard as I could, trying to give vent to the feeling. Oh my, what a time. That's for every man tonight. And woman who's never experienced Jesus Christ, the freedom of forgiven sin, walking light-footed. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Brother Branham says, as long as your sins are not forgiven, you've got a burden. But your sins, when your sins are forgiven, you become light-footed.
Amen.
You feel that you can run one more time. Be a light-footed believer.
Amen.
Let the blood of Jesus Christ cleanse your sins.
Amen.
God is more willing to forgive you for all your sins.
Amen.
God is more willing
modimo o
ikemiseditse to give you the baptism of the Holy Ghost.
Kolobetso ya
mamphetwa.
Amen. And Brother Branham, in another quotation, I'm not going to read it.
Brother Branham go supula sisimwa ke le balla sona.
He says the blood of Jesus Christ.
Ore mali amara na Jesu.
He says it's like a bleach.
Atswana li bleach.
You see this handy that we use at home.
Le abona handy eri shumisha go ga
mara.
Oba jiki.
If you take your shirt.
How tia se aparo sa
how. That's what's stained.
Se sina le dikolo
put it in there.
Dipatso wa di wa stencha ka mo.
Not long.
Isigala.
That stain would go away.
Eh di patso tse di tlaba di tsama.
So he says the blood of Jesus Christ.
Iri uri mali a Jesu Kristo.
You take your sin.
How tia se bisa how.
Drop it into the blood of Jesus Christ.
Wasi la tlhela ka mo wa dinga Jesu.
He says
all
that sin.
So na se bisa ho. Siba madi
because there is power.
Ka uba ni huna humatla
in the blood.
Amen.
This is if the devil
uri ha satan
jump into that tub of bleach.
Ah ka fufela ka mo bleaching yeo.
He says he will become my brother.
Uka
ba one issue because there is power.
Ka uba
huma in the blood of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
But the devil cannot jump into that tub of bleach.
Fela satan aka si jumpele.
He knows better.
Uti ba habuti.
Now let us come to where we can close.
Ari ke mori ka gona go tswale.
James chapter 5.
James chapter 5
verse 16.
How look you?
The Bible says,
"Bibele iri,
confess your faults one to another."
Iri ipulele ndivitsari tsa lena.
Pray one for another.
Rapelelana
that he may be healed.
Uri le gona fodiswa.
The effectual fervent prayer of a righteous man availeth much.
Tapelo ya matla ya mudumeni ya muluki ya
So it means that before you get healed,
pile a re o ka fodiswa,
you need to confess your sin.
O tlamegile o confesse dibitsa ha.
Brother says here, mostly every time when we come together,
iri ka mitla ha ri kopana,
it's a meeting for the healing of the sick.
Ke kopanelo ya phodiso ya balwe
and for the physical needs.
Liya ithokotsa tsa tse bonwana.
The emphasis is put upon that.
Ha tlhaluso ore o iphulela go
tsi. Re bolela kudu mo.
Taba e mo kudu.
Bo taba
phodiso ya nama.
Hallelujah.
But tonight
we are no bushugo bo.
We have started this revival.
Re thomile tseletso ye
for the healing of the soul.
All right.
Phodiso ya moya.
The spirit of a man.
Moya wa motho.
Let me say the healing of the soul, it is more important than the healing of the body.
It is a podiso ya na.
The greatest healing campaign,
podiso e khulu,
it is the healing of the soul.
Amen.
Amen.
We are not against the healing of the body.
Are go tlhanong le podiso ya na.
The healing of the body, Brother Bram says, it's temporal.
Amen. Brother Bram, the podiso ya na,
we can lay hands on you.
Rikamea matsuri ka rapela.
You get healed.
Wa fola.
But 2 years later,
come rabbi why me
you die of the very same disease.
Wow, talk of fala
come on, the healing of the soul,
if ela podiso ya moya,
it is eternal.
Amen.
Amen.
How is your soul healed?
Moya wa how podiso ya,
receive the baptism of the Holy Ghost.
Amogela kolobetso ya moya o mogetwa.
He says here,
wa bulela,
that's why I think so much healing becomes a failure.
Kimbo ke ginagana ngukari podiso ke ya palelo
or professed healing.
O ba tlhalwe tlhaluso ya
kaone so. First place.
Ka re la mathomo.
The people are not ready for healing.
Batho abalukela abaitukisetsa phoriso.
They won't confess their wrongs.
Batho
abaipulela
dibitsa bona.
The Bible says,
"Bibili in
confess your faults one to another."
Ipulela dibitsa lena
pray for one another.
Rapelelana.
So Brother Brian says,
Brother Brendan moa go.
Divine healing.
Phoriso ya simoya
becomes a failure.
Iya palelwa,
and he says that is the again the reason
hape ke tlhaloso
the baptism of the Holy Ghost becomes a failure.
Ya uri kolobetso ya moyo mogetho iya palelwa,
not willing
ka le bakala uri batho abaikemisetsa
to confess their wrongs.
Ipulela divitsa bona.
Skip other things here.
Iri difufete dingwe mo.
He says now we all that are here,
iri ka mokabaleng ka bo,
I sent a little thing with
ke le ka rumela se simonyana.
He's speaking of a prayer cloth.
Ubulela ka ubulela ka di saka ka di
he tells you how to get to your pastor.
Ya u tlhalusetsa uri u ya yuang muruti wa hao.
And get to come to him.
Wa ba mo khono mfithelela.
And confess your faults.
Wa bulela di bitsa hao.
And get rid of everything.
Wa tlobela di botsedi.
And lay it on there.
Wa dula mo,
there's nothing in the way.
A hoda silo botsileng ya.
God will do it.
Mudimo o tla u direla.
Don't you believe that?
Amen.
U sa u bulela se we.
In closing.
The instruction Brother Branham gives.
The instruction says Brother Branham
if you have got an unconfessed sin.
He
says you call your pastor. Confess your sins to him. Tell him your secrets. Tell him the honest truth. And expose the devil. Once Satan is exposed, then you receive the baptism.
Hallelujah.
He gives an example here. Are we still together?
Amen.
Can we say amen?
Amen.
A sister who had lived unfaithful to the husband.
Are Haitian or Sanga Apila?
Brother Bram says she committed adultery. Listen attentively, everyone. And the sister could not tell it to the husband. And she went to God. And confessed her sins to God. But the sin did not go away. She went on with her life. And thought she had confessed her sins. But as far as God is concerned, the sin was still on her. You need to confess that. Brother Bram says you need to confess that to your husband.
Brother Bram,
the sister said, I cannot. Because my husband will divorce me. Brother Branham said, it's either you need God, or God has will reject you. Now let me start reading from here. I said, sister, that don't have nothing to do with it. They can pour oil on your head till you got a gallon on them. You can fast 40 days. You can do anything.
Yeah.
They can kick you and run across the platform and scream and
holler.
But devil will stay right.
Satan,
he's got a right. As long as he's got a right to stay there, he will hold his ground. The sister said, I can't do it. I said, now sister, you come here and God in his mercy has revealed what your trouble is. Go make that right with your husband and you will get well. If you don't, then I've done all. She said, I can't do it. It will just break my home. I said, all right. I was just God's servant. I have done what God bid me to do. She started to cry. I looked back at her. Standing along the side of the door. I seen a tall man in a vision. Blue shadow standing there. And he had his hair combed sideways. Kind of wavy black hair. Your husband is black-headed, man. Tall and thin. She said, yes. And I said, he works in a Chevrolet company. Remember, Brother Branham is telling this to a sister.
Yeah.
And the sister says, yes, sir. He does. And I said,
Kari,
your husband,
Munawahao,
has got the same thing to confess to you.
She
said, not my husband. My husband is a deacon in the church.
Right.
Hey, whether you're a deacon or not, you need to confess as well.
Yeah.
I said, I don't care what he is. He's got the same thing to confess to. When he landed in England, so this brother went in England for some work.
Munna wo u unebereka ko England.
Then Brother Branham sees him in a vision.
Piano Brother Branham wo mbona kono.
Not these cheap things that we see today.
Yeah. You see,
hey, but the way you are seeing. Maybe you've done something. That's cheap. Tell me the details.
Amen.
If you've said I've committed adultery, tell me where I did it. Tell me the hotel. Tell me the room number. Tell me the number of that woman. Don't tell me some cheap things. Let me be honest with you.
Yeah.
We don't need somebody with desire.
Resentment
lies.
Amen.
We don't need anybody with resentment. Brother Branham says it's one in a generation.
Amen.
Brother Branham
was
always spot on.
Brother Branham never went to
all the time. All the time.
Amen.
Then he says, he did the same trick. And told her where he did it. And not over 3 days ago. And Brother Branham starts to describe a woman that fall in adultery with the deacon.
He
says, that woman was wearing a pink dress with black hair.
They
was in a green Chevrolet car.
And
she works for the Chevrolet company. That is working for. I said,
God,
I got 4 phones. Go call, get him up. Go somewhere. You will all make that right with God for those children's sake. I just walked out to that man that had cancer in there to pray for him. She called him. In a few moments, here they come back. Both of them with their tears running down their cheeks. She called him. They met out on the road in a car to themselves. Rest of the party drove away. They left in the same car. She said, she confessed a wrong first. And he said, you kept that in your heart all this time? And the sister said, yes. The person that told me about it a while ago told me that the day before yesterday, you was with the woman that she knew. And he said, where have you been? He said, honey, that's exactly the truth. And the people may be sitting in this meeting tonight. I know many witnesses of it. It's exactly the truth. If you'll forgive me,
how can I
forgive you? We'll ask God to forgive both of us. We'll get our children and live like men and women ought to be.
Hey,
like a Sunday school teacher. Because the sister was a Sunday school teacher. And the husband was a deacon. And they confessed their sins. They came back with their arms around one another. Coming out.
But
my wife said, you remember, honey? Will they ever come back? I said, sure, they will be back. There is the only hope to be well. And they came back with their arms around one another. By God's grace and by the authority of God's word. He says, Satan will leave you.
Satan
will leave you. And there he left. And she's the happiest little woman in this new Alabama, Indiana.
Amen.
She's testifying everywhere. And her
and her and her husband both live a victorious life. I challenge you this morning. We need to have the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
There is something between you and God. Make it right. Now, if there's something hanging over you, and if you confess it, God will not be a liar. God will give you the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
It does not take a month. Or 2 days. Or 2 weeks. But it takes a lot to repent. I challenge us today. That let us clean our lives. And when we clean our lives,
amen,
we will receive the baptism of the Holy
Ghost.
Give me a believer that has got unconfessed sin. That has got a life that is clean.
Amen.
I will show you a believer that has got the baptism of the Holy Ghost. Everywhere you are, let us close our eyes.
Amen.
You know your heart. I don't know your heart. But you know your heart. You know your condition. If you need the Holy Ghost, we read the quotation. Brother Branham says, confess your sins. Get to the pastor. Say, pastor, this is my life. I've not been living the right kind of life. And I need God to fill me with the Holy Ghost. If you want God to give you the boldness that you can make it right with God, raise your hand where you are. And say, Lord, I want to make it right with you. I want my life to be aligned with the standard and the requirement that I need to receive the baptism of the Holy Ghost. Let us not look around. If you have raised your hand, God bless you. If you have raised your hand, why don't you raise on your feet? Raise and stand on your feet. And say, brother, I'm not standing, you're not standing for me. This is a serious time with God. All of you that have raised your hand, stand on your feet. Don't look around. Don't look at your neighbor. You are the only one that need the baptism of the Holy Ghost. If you want the baptism of the Holy Ghost and you want the refilling of the Holy Ghost, stand on your feet. He is here today. To grant you the desire of your heart. Let us be reverent. Brother Branham says, the hour has come that we cannot play church anymore. We need to get serious with God.
Hallelujah.
We need to be serious with the message. Let us raise our hands. Those that are on their feet, we are going to sing a song. After we have sang a song, I'm going to call our precious pastor to come and commit us all that have stand on their feet. Those that say, Lord, it's me, O Lord. I don't want my coming to church to be in vain. I need the baptism of the Holy Ghost. I need more of you, Lord. I want my attitude to be changed. I want to be a real, genuine Christian. And I cannot be a real Christian until I receive the baptism of the Holy Ghost. Yes, you were baptized with water. That is not enough. You need to go an extra mile and get the baptism of the Holy Ghost. Friends, this is a serious matter now. We don't need to play around. We need the baptism of the Holy Ghost. Our attitude must be changed. We cannot live the way we live and be happy all the time. God must do something for us. And I want to challenge you today. God is here. And if you want the Holy Ghost, God will fill your heart. And after we have prayed,
Go make it right with God. Go make it right with your husband. Go make it right with your neighbor. And God, you will see, you, God will fill you. That's what we need. We don't need church members. We want people that are filled with the Holy Ghost. That's what we need. Friends, this is a desperate hour. This is a state of grace.
Oh! Oh, Hallelujah. It was really good. We are approaching, we are nearing the coming of the end time. Hallelujah. We are nearing home. You remember that song? We are nearing home. Hallelujah. We are nearing home. So we need such messages because we need a ticket so that we can get into the rapture. We need that ticket of the or the token of the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. So without a waste of time, but I want to be more than we did show for change, study channel and body layer. I've seen her in the presence of Almighty God. Hallelujah. So for now, we are going to sing a song, and then we talk about Brother Vincent Barutushi. And then I will be able to do more than I want to do. Amen.